Real quick, just want to go over how to put on and take off a mask. You have two parts of your mask. The outside part, which is either often blue or green, and this is your inside part, the white part. It's you know what size is the top part, because the top part has a, it's lined with, you use a very small wire, all right? What you want to do is, you want to open it up, put it on both parts of your, covers your ear, on both sides, put it above your nose. Pinch up here, make sure it comes down here, and boom, the mask is ready to go. And by the way, in case I didn't say early on, wash your hands before you put your mask on. Wash your hands. Then when it's time to take off your mask, it's very important that you don't touch the outside of your mask, because this is the contaminated part. This is the contaminated part. You want to reach down, take the loop, reach down, take the other loop, and take it off smoothly. And you do not want to touch the contaminated part. I know you've got the same question as it relates to the cloth mask. I say the little cutesy ones. At times, I'm not sure which is the outside, which is the inside, but whatever you choose to be the outside, it must stay as the outside. It must stay as the outside. On this one, we'll choose this side, the orange side, to be the outside. It does not have the wire going across, so there is no top and there is no bottom, because it's the wire that defines whether or not it is the top or bottom. Same thing, you place it on, boom, and if there were a wire, you pinch the wire. Just as a side note, the better the seal, the better the mask. The better the seal, the better the mask. Okay, the better the seal, the better the mask. Why? It keeps anything from coming in on the side, but more importantly, to your fellow citizens, it keeps materials coming out of your mouth and going out the sides and so forth, because one of the greatest benefits of the mask is that it protects other people from you. And then finally, for those who have an N95, and this is just one version of an N95, you take to the two rubber bands, and don't forget, we don't touch the outside, and we always wash our hands first. We're not touching the outside. We want to get used to not touching the outside. Why? Because for many of these masks, we're going to use them twice. And we've washed our hands first. All right. You want to put it over your head. You're not touching the outside. Put it over your mouth. Put one rubber band up, one rubber band down. We have a nice tug. Then, this is the only time that you can touch the outside. Is that you want to make sure that there's a nice seal there. Okay, good. And now this mask is ready. Just as a few side notes. If you have a beard on, or if you wear a beard, it often compromises your mask. Again, a beard often compromises your mask. Be safe out there. Safety's key, but wearing a mask, no matter what, once you leave your house, is extremely key, especially when you're leaving your house and you're going to another inside environment, or you're going to be more than 6 feet, or you're going to be less than 6 feet apart from someone else. Thank you very much. Have a good day.